This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. In music, counterpoint is the relationship between voices that are harmonically interdependent polyphony yet independent in rhythm and contour. It has been most commonly identified in the European classical tradition, strongly developing during the Renaissance and in much of the common practice period, especially in the Baroque. The term originates from the Latin punctus contra puncta, meaning point against point. Contents 1 General principles, 2 Development, 3 Species counterpoint, 31 Considerations for all species, 32 First species, 33 Second species, 34 Third species, 35 Fourth species, 36 Fifth species Florid counterpoint, 4 Contrapuntal derivations, 5 Free counterpoint, 6 Linear counterpoint, 7 Dissonant counterpoint, 8 See also 9 References, 10 Further reading, 11 External links. General principles. Counterpoint generally involves musical lines with strongly independent identities. Citation needed. Counterpoint has been used to designate a voice or even an entire composition in each era. Contrapuntally organized music writing has been subject to rules, sometimes strict ones. Chords are the simultaneous soundings of notes, whereas harmonic, vertical features are considered secondary and almost incidental when counterpoint is the predominant textural element. Counterpoint focuses on melodic interaction, only secondarily on the harmonies produced by that interaction. In the words of John Rann, it is hard to write a beautiful song. It is harder to write several individually beautiful songs that, when sung simultaneously, sound as a more beautiful polyphonic whole. The internal structures that create each of the voices separately must contribute to the emergent structure of the polyphony, which in turn must reinforce and comment on the structures of the individual voices. The way that is accomplished in detail as counterpoint development. Some examples of related compositional techniques include the round, familiar in folk traditions, the canon, and perhaps the most complex contrapuntal convention, the fugue. All of these are examples of imitative counterpoint. Species counterpoint. Species counterpoint generally offers less freedom to the composer than other types of counterpoint and therefore is called a strict counterpoint. Species counterpoint was developed as a pedagogical tool in which students progress through several species of increasing complexity, with a very simple part that remains constant, known as the cantus firmus, Latin for fixed melody. The student gradually attains the ability to write free counterpoint, that is, less rigorously constrained counterpoint, usually without a cantus firmus according to the given rules at the time. The idea is at least as old as 1532, when Giovanni Maria Lanfranco described a similar concept in his Cintil di Musica Brescia, 1533. The 16th-century Venetian theorist Zarlino elaborated on the idea in his influential Le Istituzioni Harmonici, and it was first presented in a codified form in 1619 by Lodovico Zacconi in his Pratica di Musica. Zacconi, unlike later theorists, included a few extra contrapuntal techniques, such as invertible counterpoint. In 1725, Johann Joseph Fuchs published Gradus ad Parnassum, Steps to Parnassus, in which he described 5 species, note against note, 2 notes against 1, 4 modified by others to include 3, 6, etc. notes against 1, notes offset against each other as suspensions, all the first 4 species together, as florid counterpoint. A succession of later theorists quite closely imitated Fuchs's seminal work, often with some small and idiosyncratic modifications in the rules. Considerations for all species. The following rules apply to melodic writing in each species. For each part, the final must be approached by step. If the final is approached from below, then the leading tone must be raised in a minor key. Dorian, Hypodorian, Aeolian, Hypoaeolian, but not in Phrygian or Hypophrygian mode. Thus, in the Dorian mode on D, a C sharp is necessary at the cadence permitted. Melodic intervals are the perfect fourth, fifth, and octave, as well as the major and minor second, major and minor third, and ascending minor sixth. The ascending minor sixth must be immediately followed by motion downwards if writing 2 skips in the same direction, something that must be only rarely done. The second must be smaller than the first, and the interval between the first and the third note may not be dissonant. The 3 notes should be from the same triad. If this is impossible, they should not outline more than 1 octave in general. Do not write more than 2 skips in the same direction. If writing a skip in one direction, it is best to proceed after the skip with motion in the other direction. The interval of a tritone in 3 notes should be avoided. For example, an ascending melodic motion FAB, as is the interval of a seventh in 3 notes. There must be a climax or high point movement in the line countering the cantus firmus. This usually occurs somewhere in the middle of exercise and must occur on a strong beat. An outlining of a seventh is avoided within a single line moving in the same direction, and, in all species, the following rules govern the combination of the parts. The counterpoint must begin and end on a perfect consonance. Contrary motion should predominate. Perfect consonances must be approached by oblique or contrary motion. Imperfect consonances may be approached by any type of motion. The interval of a tenth should not be exceeded between two adjacent parts unless by necessity. Build from the base, upward. First species in first species. Counterpoint, each note in every added part. Parts being also referred to as lines or voices. Sounds against one note in the cantus firmus. Notes in all parts are sounded simultaneously, and move against each other simultaneously. Since all notes in first species counterpoint are whole notes, rhythmic independence is not available in the present context. A step is a melodic interval of a half or whole step. A skip is an interval of a third or fourth C steps, and skips an interval of a fifth or larger is referred to as a leap. A few further rules given by Fuchs, by study of the Palestrina style, and usually given in the works of later counterpoint pedagogues, are as follows. Begin and end on either the unison, octave, or fifth, unless the added part is underneath, in which case begin and end only on unison or octave. Use no unisons except at the beginning or end. Avoid parallel fifths or octaves between any two parts, and avoid hidden parallel fifths or octaves, that is, movement by similar motion to a perfect fifth or octave, unless one part sometimes restricted to the higher of the parts moves by step. Avoid moving in parallel fourths. In practice, Palestrina and others frequently allowed themselves such progressions, especially if they do not involve the lowest of the parts. Avoid moving in parallel thirds or sixths for very long. Attempt to keep any two adjacent parts within a tenth of each other, unless an exceptionally pleasing line can be written by moving outside of that range. Avoid having any two parts move in the same direction by skip. Attempt to have as much contrary motion as possible. Avoid dissonant intervals between any two parts, major or minor second, major or minor seventh, any augmented or diminished interval, and perfect fourth in many contexts. In the following example in two parts, the cantus firmus is the lower part. The same cantus firmus is used for later examples also, each as in the Dorian mode. Short example of first species counterpoint. The accented beat must have only consonants. Perfect or imperfect, the unaccented beat may have dissonance, but only as a passing tone, i.e. it must be approached and left by step in the same direction. Avoid the interval of the unison except at the beginning or end of the example, except that it may occur on the unaccented portion of the bar. Use caution with successive accented perfect fifths or octaves. They must not be used as part of a sequential pattern. Short example of second species counterpoint. Neighbor figure. Lastly, a double passing tone allows two dissonant passing tones in a row. The figure would consist of four notes moving in the same direction by step. The two notes that allow dissonance would be beat 2 and 3 or 3 and 4. The dissonant interval of a fourth would proceed into a diminished fifth, and the next note would resolve at the interval of a sixth. This is an example of a double passing tone in which the two middle notes are a dissonant interval from the cantus firmus, a fourth and a diminished fifth. This is an example of a descending double neighbor figure against a cantus firmus. This is an example of an ascending double neighbor figure against a cantus firmus. Fourth species in fourth species counterpoint. Some notes are sustained or suspended in an added part while notes move against them in the given part, often creating a dissonance on the beat, followed by the suspended note then changing and catching up to create a subsequent consonance with the note in the given part as it continues to sound as before. Fourth species counterpoint is called expanded when the added part notes vary in length among themselves. The technique requires chains of notes sustained across the boundaries determined by beat, and so creates syncopation. Also, it is important to note that a dissonant interval is allowed on beat 1 because of the syncopation created by the suspension. Short example of fourth species counterpoint. Fifth species florid counterpoint. In fifth species counterpoint, sometimes called florid counterpoint, the other four species of counterpoint are combined within the added parts. In the example, the first and second bars are second species, the third bar is third species, the fourth and fifth bars are third and embellished fourth species, and the final bar is first species. Short example of florid counterpoint. Major or perhaps minor third, etc. Compare, in 12-tone technique, the inversion of the tone row, which is the so-called prime series turned upside-down note. In invertible counterpoint, including double and triple counterpoint, the term inversion is used in a different sense altogether. At least one pair of parts is switched, so that the one that was higher becomes lower. See inversion in counterpoint. It is not a kind of imitation, but a rearrangement of the parts retrograde, whereby an imitative voice sounds the melody backwards in relation the leading voice retrograde inversion where the imitative voice sounds the melody backwards and upside down at once augmentation when in one of the parts in imitative counterpoint the note values are extended in duration compared to the rate at which they were sounded when introduced diminution when in one of the parts in imitative counterpoint the note values are reduced in duration compared to the rate at which they were sounded when introduced free counterpoint see also, free composition. From a historical perspective, the didactic strict counterpoint was used for musical training purposes from the Renaissance to the present day, but was never employed in practice broadly speaking, due to the development of harmony. From the Baroque period on, most contrapuntal compositions were written in the style of free counterpoint. This means that the general focus of the composer had shifted away from how the intervals of added melodies related to a cantus firmus, and more toward how they related to each other nonetheless. According to Kent Kennan, actual teaching in that fashion free counterpoint did not become widespread until the late 19th century. Young composers of the 17th and 18th centuries, such as Mozart, Beethoven, and Schumann, were still educated in the style of strict counterpoint, but in practice, they would look for ways to expand on the traditional concepts of the subject main features of free counterpoint. All forbidden chords, such as second inversion, seventh, ninth, etc., can be used freely in principle of harmony. Chromaticism is allowed. The restrictions about rhythmic placement of dissonance are removed. It is possible to use passing tones on the accented beat. Appoggiatura is available. Dissonance tones can be approached by leaps. Linear counterpoint. Linear counterpoint from Stravinsky's octet. Duodecoupled dissonant counterpoint. Dissonant counterpoint was originally theorized by Charles Seeger as at first purely a schoolroom discipline, consisting of species counterpoint but with all the traditional rules reversed. First species counterpoint must be all dissonances, establishing dissonance, rather than consonance, as the rule, and consonances are resolved through a skip, not step. He wrote that the effect of this discipline was one of purification. Other aspects of composition, such as rhythm, could be dissonated by applying the same principle. Charles Seeger, on dissonant counterpoint, Modern Music 7, No. 4 of June to July 1930, 25-26. Seeger was not the first to employ dissonant counterpoint, but was the first to theorize and promote it. Other composers who have used dissonant counterpoint, if not in the exact manner prescribed by Charles Seeger, include Ruth Crawford Seeger, Carl Ruggles, Henry Cowell, Henry Brandt, Dane Rudhyer, Lou Harrison, Bartine Vallon, and Arnold Schoenberg. See also Music Portal Counter Melody Hauptstimme Polyphony. Voice leading references. Carrot Lates, Stephen G. 2008 The Complete Musician 2 ed. New York, New York, Oxford University Press, Inc. p. Carrot Felix Salzer and Carl Schachter Counterpoint in Composition, The Study of Voice Leading New York, Stanley Persky, City University of New York p. Further reading Kurth, Ernst 1991 Foundations of Linear Counterpoint. In Ernst Kurth, Selected Writings, Selected and Translated by Lee Allen Rothfarb, Forward by Ian Bent, Cambridge Studies in Music Theory and Analysis 2 Cambridge and New York, Cambridge University Press Paperback Reprint 2006 ISBN 0-521-35522-2 Cloth, ISBN 0-521-02824-8 PBK Prout, Ebenezer 1890 Counterpoint, Strict and Free London, Augener. Virginia Tech Multimedia Music Dictionary, Dissonant Counterpoint Examples and Definition. Demystifying Tonal Counterpoint or How to Overcome Your Fear of Composing Counterpoint Exercises by Christopher Dylan Bailey, Composer at Columbia University. Counterpointer, Software Tutorial for the Study of Counterpoint by Jeffrey Evans, Bacchus Contrapuntist by Dan Brown, Music Critic from Cornell University, from his web book Why Bach Contrapuntal, a collaborative arts project by Benjamin Skepper, V.E. Counterpoint and Polyphony. Canon Catch English Cadence False Relation Fugue Imitation Reisserkar. Round Subject Voice Voice Leading VE Musical Textures Monophony Homorhythm and Homophony Heterophony Polyphony and Counterpoint Micropolyphony Authority Control GND, 4032307-9 NDL, 00572521.